Yeah, good afternoon, YouTube. So I'm saving off some of the leftover citric acid mix that I used to descale the water heater. I have 2 gallon jugs full, and I'll save that for household cleaning over the year. But one thing I wanted to try here, my utility sink, it's stainless steel, but I get rust forming on the bottom because I wash off a lot of steel parts, and you get the grinding dust and metal chips and all that, and that sticks to the bottom and rusts. So I thought I would try the little bit I have left here. It's got all the sediment and everything, so I figure I would pour this in here. And I figure this might have to sit for a while. It's taking that off pretty quick. Yeah, so let's see how this thing works here. Get that out of the, go hang that back up. So this is fairly acid, but it doesn't seem to be terribly harsh on your hands. You do want to rinse them off afterwards, and I guess if you're sensitive, you could wear rubber gloves. The only thing I noticed, I got a little scrape right there, and you know, it's like putting your finger in a pickle jar. You know, it's that kind of acid, or lemon juice. Citric acid is one of the major components in lemon juice. Oh yeah, I think that'll do the trick right there. A little bit of chemical action, a little bit of scrubbing. Just give it a few minutes for the acid to do its job. Pop this out, get the drain. Rinse everything down. Look at that, all nice and clean. Yeah, there we go. Looks like brand new. So that descaling stuff, I mean, it dissolves water spots, rust, things like that, and that's what happens with the stainless steel. You get the water spots when the water dries on it, and you get the steel dust and shavings and grinding residue end up here, and they stick in place and rust. But yeah, 5-10 minutes with that citric acid and it's clean. And that's biodegradable. There's no volatile chemicals, no odor. Fairly easy on the skin. It's not like using some really harsh chemicals. So I think I'll let that dry. I gotta put a magnet on this handle. This is another handy thing to keep over by the sink. Got a little scoop and a funnel and a measuring cup, a little toothbrush. Really handy to put all your cleaning supplies and whatnot up there. Yeah, so that's what you can do. You know, don't just dump it down the drain. Like here, dumping it down the drain, but I plugged the drain up for a while and cleaned out the sink and then dumped it down the drain. 2 gallons left for household cleaning during the year. And it's just really nice having a bottle like that. If you need to use it, it's there. There's no cost to it at all other than storing it. Dump some in the dishwasher, helps clean out the hard water deposits in there. If you've got some glassware that might be spotted, soak it in that. Shower heads, I showed you that earlier. That was in vinegar, but this would work good for shower heads or, you know, cleaning your faucet sprayers, whatever. So yeah, don't just throw that out when you're done. Now, you don't want to use this to descale the machine anymore. So I always put an X on the cap that says, hey, this has been used. I label what it is. I think it was earlier this year, I used about 1/2 gallon of the old vinegar. I was replacing the valve in a toilet, and the inside of the tank had a lot of hard water deposits built up. I couldn't get the gasket for the new valve to seal on the bottom because it was very rough with the water deposits. So I dumped about 1/2 gallon of used vinegar or this in that tank, let it sit for 1/2 day, and then all the hard water deposits were gone and the new valve went in and it seals perfectly. There's just all sorts of little uses for this. If you have it around, you'll find uses. So yeah, if you have any favorite uses for old vinegar or something like that, citric acid mix, post up in the comment section below. I'll put some of the other descaling videos over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.